Members of the East Cheam Musical Appreciation Society, we come to our interview.
Oh, dear.
No, we shall be going on, of course. You'll be most attentive to our humble efforts, but I'm sure we all feel the need for a little refreshment. No. Mrs. Farley will now pass amongst you with some tea and crumpets while the ensemble gets stuck into some flippant background music there, all right? All right, lads, as much Ivan Novello as you can knock out in 5 minutes, all right? Ada, no slipping out for a start.
A delightful idea of yours, Mr. Hancock, to hold these musical evenings.
Oh, I'm so glad that you think so, Vicar.
So kind of you to throw open your house like this.
Not at all. I'm hoping it'll become another Glyndebourne.
I especially enjoyed your play.
Oh, on the old cello. Yes. Well, I love it, you know. It's my life. As my good friend Sir Adrian used to say, there's nothing like a good old scrape on the old cello. You can't whack it, he used to say. Those were his exact words, yes. Have a crumpet.
Thank you. Yes, it's really wonderful of a man like you
to
bring culture to our little village.
Oh, not at all. It's my pleasure, Your Honor.
Thank you. I don't mind telling you, many people were very dubious when they heard you were coming to live in our community. I mean, you're being a music hall comic. They felt you might lower the tone of the district.
Oh, my word, no need to worry about that. Now, we comedians have our posh moment the same as what you gents do. Yes, I'm considered quite a toff in some circles. No need to worry on that score, Vic. All this comicking and such is just a job with me, you know. My real interests lie in the world of beauty and the arts. Music, sculpture, opera, painting, rug making, all that love. My home is always open to you intellectuals, the village elders, so to speak. And by the way, you might see what you can do to further my ambitions in the social field. I like to mix with people in my own caliber, you know what I mean. His lordship and his good lady up at the manor there. I believe you have dinner with them occasionally.
Yes, I do.
Yes, well, you won't forget the name, will you, Hancock? Anthony Hancock?
No, I won't forget.
Good lad, Vic. See you Sunday. Good lad. Good boy. Hello, Colonel.
Hi.
See, you did quite well out of the redundancy money then.
Yes.
Yes. Oh. And his worship, the Borough Surveyor. Charm. If I can ever help you out on the council, don't forget the name, will you, Hancock? Anthony Hancock.
Charming place you got here, Hancock. Big success for the first gathering. Might well become a regular thing with us, you know.
Well, I do hope so. My home is your home, you know. It's
Thanks.
A bit out of the village, a bit off the beaten track, but that's what I like about it. Peaceful and quiet. Far from the madding crowd's unnobbled strife, as the poet has it. As soon as I saw this place, I knew it was the ideal place for a man of culture, you know. Secluded, old world, tasteful, peaceful, quiet. You can't wait. Hang on. Snag with it. What a daft place to put an aerodrome at the bottom of my garden.
I say, Hancock, does this sort of thing happen very often?
Oh, no. It's most unusual, this. No, you will enjoy coming here. It's an ideal place for a quiet little get-together.
Oh, thank heaven for that.
Oh, hang on.
Oh, my God, another one! Is this your idea of a joke, Hancock?
My dear sir, I
mean, after all, getting us down here to this shaking monstrosity.
Have a care, sir. Watch your language. Remember, we have a member of the clergy present.
Very considerate of you, Mr. Hancock. Thank you. But I do see the Colonel's point. It's rather disconcerting to have aeroplanes taking off halfway through the poet and peasant.
Oh, no, you soon get used to it. After the first half dozen Viscounts have been over, you don't notice it, you know. You begin to look forward to them. You miss them when they don't go over. Of course, they're splendid in the middle of the dambuster's mark.
I wouldn't have come here if I'd known this sort of thing was going to happen. My nerves are in a shocking state. I must have a glass of brandy or something.
What do you mean, have a brandy? You've had the lot. 4 bottles. No wonder they keep coming over with his nose flashing away there out the window. You had put anybody off course. All right, ladies and gentlemen, relax. Don't let this spoil your beautiful evening. Please, relax and enjoy yourself. Hello, hello. Watch it. It's all right. Another one. Don't worry, don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry about it. Watch this go. Watch this go. Louder, louder. Oh, it's the New York flight. He's a bit late tonight. There we are. Oh, that wasn't so bad, was it? If you hadn't known what it was, you'd never have noticed it.
I'm not staying in this house another minute. I think you ought to be ashamed of yourself inviting us to a place like this. We might all have been killed.
Oh, don't go yet, Duchess. Have another crumpet.
Come, Henry.
A disgraceful exhibition, sir.
Oh, shut up. You're not going, are you, Vic? Stay back. Well, it's all right.
Well, I'm very kind, but I really must be off. One, 2 calls to make, you know.
Yes.
If I were you, Hancock, I should move. You won't be very welcome in the village after this episode, I can tell you.
Well, it's not my fault. I can't help the...
Good afternoon to you, sir.
Oh, I hope your medals go rusty. Don't you need ladies and gentlemen, please. We artists must stick together. I shall report you to the union. You'll all have to turn your fiddles in.
Well, goodbye, Mr. Hancock. I'm so sorry. I understand how you feel. I get the same sort of thing when the bells start up on Sunday.
Well, don't just stand there, madam. Start sweeping the crumpets up. Well, that's it. That's my reputation in this business gone for a burt. What am I going to do? I should have been sitting pretty there, seat on the council, mixing with all the gentry like I was born to do. Well, I just have to move out of this village. But a knob I was destined to be, and a knob I am going to be. Hello, hello. Hang on.
Just the place you're looking for. Ideal place to retire in, that is.
Well, what do you think, Emily?
Well, it is on the coast, isn't it?
Oh, it's on the coast. You're sure of that?
Certainly it's on the coast. Look on the map there. It's a nice big bit of land you've got there.
Oh, dear.
Well, what's the matter? You've got 2 acres there.
Yes, they're halfway up the side of the cliff.
Well, you've got to be particular, Dad.
Where is the house in relation to the coastline?
Well, there's the house, and that's the coastline running along there.
Oh, I see. Good gracious, it appears to go through the dining room.
Well, yes, it does overhang the cliff a bit. It does overhang the cliff a bit, but that's the style, cantilevered, very modern. Pull up one of the floorboards, you can fish and watch television at the same time.
Well, I don't know.
Well, it seems a lot better than that other house he tried to sell us.
Oh, wait a minute. Look, lady, I'm trying to explain that to you. I had no idea they were going to put a road through the kitchen. And how could I possibly have known I'm going to pull the place down 3 days after you moved in?
Well, there's no danger of it happening this time.
Oh, no, no, no. This is dead on the level. I wouldn't sell you a dicey property. You wouldn't find a better place than that anywhere.
Yes, well. All right, then. How much?
$8,500 or nearest offer.
$300.
It's the nearest offer I've had yet. I'll take it. All right, Dad. Well, you don't want to hang around here any longer. I'll have the deeds posted to you. Nice of you to come. It's a delightful property. You'll love it. Will? Scratch off that derelict lifeboat shed. I sold it.
I want my money back.
Hancock, my best customer. Sit down, son.
Never mind about sitting down.
Sit down, relax. Come here. Can I interest you in house number 89?
No, you cannot. You can refund to me the money that you wheedled out of me on house number 88.
You mean you're not satisfied?
I am not.
What's wrong with it?
What's wrong with it? There are airfields at the bottom of my garden.
Get away.
Yes, an airfield. Dirty great runways. Not... Watch it, watch it. Let the artist speak, please. Dirty great runways, not 12 yards away from the outdoor barbecue.
Well, what's wrong with that? What's wrong with a little vibration now and then?
A little vibration now and again? You try and get from the kitchen to the dining room when there's a flight of Sabre jets going over. Worse than a cakewalk on a fairground. I want my money back.
I'm sorry, mate. You can't have it. I showed you all over that property. You went in it with your eyes open.
Yes, you did. During a dense fog. Most convenient. I couldn't see the house and all the planes were grounded.
I showed you on the map. The airfield and the runways were clearly marked.
You told me that was an American baseball pitch with very wide markings.
Well, I'm sorry, mate. The contract says that no money can be refunded under any circumstances.
That was not in the contract.
Oh, yes, it was. That little bit in Latin.
You twister, you told me that was the firm's motto. Oh.
You just got to face it. You've got to put up with it. There's nothing you can do about it.
It's no use to me now. I'm finished in each team after last night's fiasco. They'll never have me as one of their laddie gentry now. Don't show me face in the high street. The natives will stone me. It's me with the ducking stool, mate. I can see that.
All right. You're breaking my heart here. Here, I'll tell you what I'll do with you. We've been mates a long time. I'll buy it back from you.
How much?
750 quid.
But I paid 5,000 for it.
Do me a favor. I'm not paying 5,000 nigger for a place backing onto an airfield.
Well, I did.
Yeah. When am I going to find another mug like you? How dare you come in here trying to sell me duff property at exorbitant prices? I got a good mind to have the law on you. Apart from the airfield, how can you have the audacity to sit there and offer me a place riddled with dry rot for 5,000 nicker?
There is no dry rot.
You look in the cellar.
Sid, what else is wrong with this place you forgot to mention?
Oh, nothing. Just that bit of woodworm.
What woodworm?
In the furniture. All them little holes all over the place.
I pointed out those things to you. You told me they were to let the air in to ventilate the wood.
I'll tell you what, 500 nigger, that's all it's worth.
You've already offered me 750.
Oh, yeah, but the worms have gone further in since then.
Now, you're not having it. It reeks of shabby practice. Buy it off me for 500 and sell it to some poor unsuspecting mug for 5,000. Well, you're not doing it. I'm not giving you the chance to defraud the public anymore.
So what are you going to do?
I am going to flog it to some poor unsuspecting mug for 5,000. Good day to you. Can I borrow your telephone?
Yeah, what for?
Just want to ring the Air Ministry and find out when the next dense fog is coming up. So much for the outer fabric of this noble edifice. What a pity about that dense fog. I would so like you to have seen that beautiful panoramic scenery one can enjoy from the outdoor barbecue. Yes, 20 miles of unlimited scenery over the lush Surrey hills. Beautiful, right in the middle of the Greenbelt area, unspoiled countryside, completely secluded, not a soul within miles.
Is it quiet and peaceful?
Quiet and peaceful. So quiet and peaceful at night time you can hear the birds walking around their nests.
It does seem nice, doesn't it, Bert? This is the first house we've seen since we've been married.
Oh, you're newlyweds. Oh, how very delightful. Stepping out together on life's long and tortuous highway. Oh, you've touched me, you have. Oh, what a lucky couple you are to start your married life under such idyllic surroundings. You couldn't do better than this. I can see you now, sir, coming home from a hard day in the city, walking up the garden path with the Gamp and the bowler and the little lady, your good lady wife there, waiting in the porch to greet you, which commands glorious views over rolling woodland valleys. This, then, can be yours for mere money. A paltry 6,000 is all I'm asking. And this love nest can be yours.
If it's so wonderful, why are you moving?
Didn't you read the advert? It said so. Present owner forced to sell cheaply owing to new employment abroad. Yes, I'm off to Abyssinia in the morning. Building a new dam over the Ganges.
It's in India.
Yes, it's going to be a big one. Well, I'm sure you can't do better than this. What do you say?
Well, I'd like to have a word about it with me wife.
Well, do hurry up, because I've got some other people waiting to see it. They'll be here in a minute. Oh.
We've decided. We'll take it.
Thank goodness you had me worried there for a minute.
Will you take a check?
I'll take it any way you like. Fivers, farthings, checks, anything. Come along. Where's that checkbook now, sir? I'm sure you'll find that. There we are. That's it.
I left me pen at home.
I've got a pen over here. That's all right. Now, there we are. Hey, Hancock. 16,000. There we are. 6,000.
What's that noise?
What's that? That one? Which one? Oh, that one. Yeah, well, that's probably the fridge starting up. Hey, Hancock, 16th of December.
It sounds like an aeroplane getting ready to take off.
Can't be that, madam. No. Hang on. Tell me, the fog's lifted.
Oh, let's have a look at the views from the
garden. You can't see anything, dear. I'm afraid this is very written to me. Oh, well, we'll do something else.
What's happening? The room's shaking.
Don't ask me, mate. I'm just a... What?
The room's shaking.
Oh!
Hang on. It must be you. You've got Asian flu or yellow jack or something. Here we are, Hancock. Enter the Hancock. Oh, shut up. Come on now, hurry up and sign.
Well, what was all that about? What happened?
What happened, you may well ask. It's you, sir. You were shaking like a leaf. Are you drunk?
It wasn't, Tim. It was the house shaking. I don't like it here, Bert. I'm frightened.
It's just an air tremor, madam. It's Stromboli going off. It does occasionally every 1,000 years. There's nothing to worry about. Their last flight, they're pulling out today.
Oh, we can't live here, Bertie. It might fall down.
Please, there's nothing wrong with the place. 5,000.
Well, you twist it if you think we're buying this, you're mistaken.
2,500.
Will you get out of our way? I'm leaving.
1,750 and a packet of headache powders.
Get out of my way.
Well, name your own price then. Pick that gate up. Kills me. Come in.
Now, I've seen your advert. I haven't got long. I'd like to look the place over if I may.
It's very nice. I've got panoramic seat. I can't leave here, you see. It's got panoramic seat all the time. Come along.
Yes, well, I'm only interested in the house, you see. I'm a surveyor.
Yes.
Now, I want a sound structure. Have you got dry rotten woodworm?
No, not a touch anywhere.
Oh, we'll soon see about that. The dry rotten woodworm test, my dear.
You got raving mad?
Hello. Just as I thought, rotten right the way through. 500 off for that.
Yes, all right, yes.
Yes, walls.
No, there's nothing wrong with the walls. I promise you that. They're a sound. Oh. Servinatch, I must have papered over it.
Servinatch?
Yes.
Through the front garden?
Yes, that's right. Yes. The milkman, he likes a cup of tea when he comes down.
Yes. No mantelpiece, eh?
No. Yeah. 200 then? 200.
Yes. That's 300 off for the wall, isn't it?
Yes.
200 for that.
Yes, I'm a reasonable man.
Well, what about the wiring, then?
Oh, it's very good. I just had it put in.
Yes,
it's a lovely job. Here it is. Help yourself.
Oh, yes. Hello.
That's the kitchen, yes. It's the bathroom. Oh, the lounge, yes. Yeah, that's next door.
Yes.
Oh, well, that's the knock, anyway.
Well, we'll knock another 700 off for that.
Yes.
The furniture doesn't look too good, do it?
No.
Ah, woodworm.
No, I've just had it treated.
You haven't.
I
Dad, you can't blame me. It's not my fault. You should have had the place insured. You should have insured it against falling into the sea.
It fell in before we got there. No, it's your fault. When you sold it to us, you said it was supposed to be hanging over the edge of the cliff. You said it was built that way.
And so it was. Nothing wrong with the house. The cliff wasn't very good.
We want our money back.
Now, wait a minute, lady. You can't make me the scapegoat for the whims of nature.
We want another house.
And for nothing as well.
I can't understand you two. What's so attractive about having a house? A couple as young as you two want to go and bury yourselves in the country. What for? What's happened to your spirit of adventure?
We're both 82.
82, what a marvelous age. Go where you like, do as you please. Nah, you don't want a cottage in the country with roses round the door, logs burning in the fire, a big fat cat on the hearth rug?
Don't we?
No. That's what you want. A converted ex-Navy motor torpedo boat. For a mere 800 knickerpop, you can be the skipper of that fine craft. Screaming across the waves at 40 knots. Headed for the Spice Islands, 4 sheets to the wind. Adventure unlimited. 2 soldiers of fortune diving for pearls in the South Seas. And Granny up there, right up in a crow's nest, in a sarong, being worshipped by the natives. Can't you see it?
Yes, yes. Ship ahoy! Avast there, ye lovers! Batten down those hatches! Full speed ahead! Avast there, ye swamps!
Sit down!
Oh dear.
We want a house!
Ah, blimey, I haven't got one. Thank you.
You still offering me £500 for that house of mine?
Yeah.
Sold.
You'll find the deeds are in order.
Oh, sure. Here we are, Dad. Just come to Anne. Pretty lucky, this. Hancock's Folly, East Cheam, with panoramic scenery that can be enjoyed from the outdoor barbecue and 20 miles of uninterrupted views over the Surrey Hills. 4,000 nigger.
Sid, I think if you're thinking of flogging it, there's something you ought to know.
Yeah? Now. Yes?
Yeah, well, there's a few minor repairs to be done to the property. And in view of that, we always include a few things free gratis and for nothing. I think you better take them. Here, what, Dad? You'll find that handy. And there's a little book that's very, very handy for bricklaying. Thank you very much. And let me wish you the very best of luck.
Thank you very much.
You'd be an estate agent. Well, what can I do for you?
As soon as you sold me a house for $6,000 that has fallen down, seeing as you've just made $3,500 on the rubble, I thought the least thing you would do would be to find me someone else to live.
Yeah, why not? Now, how do you like motor torpedo boats?
No.
No. What about a converted windmill?
No, thank you.
On bread supply, all mod cons. And the blades have all been fitted with rubber so that when it rains, it keeps the windows clean.
No.
Here, I've got a nice pottery kiln going in Staffordshire. Full central heating. They're still using it.
Look, Sid, I...
All right, wait a minute. Here, what about a disused oast house in Kent? Hasn't been used for years. You could get drunk on the smell of the fumes.
No, I don't
know. Hey, what about an old blacksmith's forge?
See, haven't you got any normal houses with four walls and sloping roofs? You know the sort of thing I like, a nice detached in a nice residential area where I can entertain the local gentry and make me debut in village society. Get up the social scale a bit. I can't do that from a pottery kiln in Staffordshire.
No, there's nothing else here on my books, boy. Yeah?
Sid?
Yes?
The Warren Pottswood's vacant again. The couple we sold it to have just moved out.
Good girl, Em. Did you hear that? There's a stroke of luck. Boy, just come on the market. The Warren Pottswood. Now, this is right up your alley, and it's only 2,500 nicker.
Wait a minute. How far away is the nearest aerodrome?
20 miles away.
How far away is the nearest woodworm?
No woodworm here. Guaranteed. There's a surveyor's report that surveyed it.
How long ago was it condemned?
It hasn't been condemned. It's only been built 3 years ago.
Well, there must be something wrong with it. You don't go around flogging brand new houses with nothing wrong with them for £2,500. Let's have a look at the area it's in. Show us the map. Not one of yours. Survey map.
There she is.
Yes, well, there's no aerodrome. Pleasantly secluded. Nice residential area. No woodworm. Seems perfect.
It is perfect, mate. You can go and see that any time you like. I've got nothing to hide. That's a genuine bona fide house. It's the only one I got on the books. Look at it there. Nothing to bother you for miles around. Situated all by itself in that beautiful little woodland valley.
All right, then I'll buy it.
You're a clever boy because you couldn't have done a better thing. This is a beautiful little property, let me tell you. And you can now hold your musical evenings with impunity. You'll be the local squire in no time.
Thank you. I'm glad you've realized you can't flog me rubbish anymore. Let that be a lesson to you. Good day.
Ta-da. Leo, cross off the Warren Pottswood. I sold it again. Oh, it's a lovely place to hold musical evenings, that is. Oh, dear.
Hello, big boy. Lovely view, isn't it? Lovely view from up here. Nice fresh air. Crumpets are just drying out. They'll be coming up in a minute.
Crumpets?
Oh, so that's the attitude, is it? What's the matter with you? I thought you'd like a bit of fresh air. Hang on to this a minute. Right. Very well. If you can't play it, row it.
Thank you.